Soldiers went offshore to fight. We had our own tensions here at home on Soames Island in the northern end of Wellington Harbour. It's had an interesting history, which includes being an internee camp during both wars for many German Tongans and Samoans.
The Maoris called it Matiu, that chunk of land out there in the middle of Wellington Harbour. But we know it as Soames Island.
The island's close enough to keep an eye on, but far enough to keep people out of sight. During World War I, German men, either living in New Zealand or the Pacific, were interned there.
In World War I, very few Germans from the islands were actually brought to New Zealand and interned. They didn't like it very much. It was too cold for them in Wellington.
The island was also used as a quarantine camp for soldiers coming back from Europe who fell ill. Another 25 years later, it was again used as an internee camp during World War II to house over 186 Japanese, Europeans and Germans, including Samoan and Tongan men from the islands with German ancestry. But Soames wasn't the only internment camp in New Zealand. German nationals were also sent to Motuihi Island in Auckland in both wars as well.
The main group of Germans who came to Auckland, to Motuihi, were the officials, the German officials and the governor. And they lived on Motuihi Island where they actually had a fairly easy life. They could come and go to Auckland and go shopping. They had probably as good a lifestyle as most people in Auckland at the time. And they resented it, but they accepted it.
After World War II, the camps on both islands were taken down and are today popular spots with tourists and is under the eye of the Department of Conservation.